Hey guys, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on debatably one of the most exciting engines in the world right now, and that is the BMW S58 engine. Found predominantly in the newest G80 M3 as well as the G82 M4. So the BMW S58 is a 3-liter inline six twin turbocharged direct injected engine. So following basically the same formula with these turbo engines that BMW has followed since the introduction of the N54 in 2007. Obviously they've stuck with that 3-liter design through the N54, N55, S55, the B58, now all the way up to the BMW S58 engine. For anyone who thinks this may just be a glorified B58 engine, it's not. It's totally different. Over 80% of the parts on the S58 are redesigned and different from the parts found on the BMW B58. So despite it being based on that B58 design, it's very loosely based on it, and a lot of the parts are totally redesigned on the S58. The block and the bore and stroke, all of that is even different compared to the B58. On the S58, BMW opted for a wider cylinder bore and a shorter stroke. Part of that helps cylinder head flow by being able to fit larger valves in there. And it's also a little bit easier to achieve big power numbers with a slightly shorter stroke, albeit a little bit worse for low end torque and performance. BMW also lowered the compression ratio to 9.3:1 on the S58, down from 11:1 on the B58. So that reduction in compression, again, really helps with achieving those big power goals and just big power in general. We already touched on briefly the improved cylinder head flow. On top of that, the cylinder head on the S58 is actually 3D printed, and that helps with precision and ultimately helps improve oil and coolant flow through that cylinder head. Specs for the S58 are pretty incredible on paper. BMW does have technical training guides or documents on the S58 that you can pull up and dive into all of the specifics. Looking at the very baseline specs, don't even paint the full picture for the S58, but nonetheless, it has some pretty insane internals. So looking at the crankshaft first, the crankshaft is a forged chrome molybdenum heat-treated steel, and the crank pins are spherically ground, which helps the bearings run smoother. Ultimately, this kind of manufacturing on a crankshaft is generally only seen on true race spec engines, so already looking great for the S58. On top of that, it has cracked steel forged connecting rods as well as forged pistons. So fully forged rotating assembly there, and even takes it a step further with the forged internals. Not all forged internals are created equal. Some are stronger than others depending on design aspects, and the S58 certainly has a lot of great stuff going for it there. Again, this doesn't even paint the full picture. If you look at that technical training document and start diving into all the different design aspects and systems within the engine, it's clear that BMW threw really a lot at this engine. Makes you wonder whether or not this is one of BMW's last fully gasoline-powered M3 or M4s, just based on the amount of technology and innovation they really threw into the S58. So again, looking at all the specifics, the oil system, the coolant channels, coolant flow, all of that stuff, it's just an incredibly well-designed engine from top to bottom. I wrote an article a couple of years ago about the S58, talking about performance potential, and it was kind of speculation, but just looking at the specs of this engine, it was pretty clear it was something special, and this wasn't just your standard, you know, this wasn't going to be anything like the BMW B58, which is already a great engine and a highly capable engine, but it was clear that the S58 had taken things to a completely new level and really something that we haven't seen with any previous BMW engines, even looking at the S55 and the previous gen, F80 M3 and F82 M4. The S58 is really just taking things to an entirely different level. There's so much that goes into this engine. There's so much design and technology that it's impossible to cover everything, but it does utilize dual high pressure fuel pumps. The fuel system is capable of 350 bar, which is just over 5,000 PSI. So very high pressure direct injection system, which is great for emissions and for performance. Thanks to the dual high pressure fuel pump setup, the S58 engine can also handle very heavy E85 blends on a completely stock fuel system. So if you're looking to tune and mod the car and run, say, an E40 or E50 blend, that is no problem for the S58's fuel system. Incredibly capable, and all of that translates into the M3 and M4 being incredibly capable cars and putting down power numbers that haven't really been seen with many 3-liter engines in the past and are even competitive with engines that offer twice the displacement and also use forced induction. So already these G80 M3s and G82 M4s have already broken into the nines in the quarter mile on bone stock turbos with really nothing more than a tune E85 or an E85 blend, and some have downpipes and an intake, but that's really the bulk of it, is just a tune and dumping some E85 fuel into the tank. And these cars are pretty capable of running in the high nines. Some on stock turbos have even managed around 9.7, 9.8 seconds in the quarter mile. Incredibly impressive for, you know, stock full weight sedans on street tires. And they're trapping these quarter miles at 135 to 140 plus miles an hour. So again, really talking about supercar level performance here and stuff that a lot of even forced induction, you know, supercharged twin turbo V8s, numbers that a lot of those engines and cars just can't even achieve. 0 to 60, especially since BMW opted to offer xDrive or all-wheel drive as an option on the newer G80 and G82s. Of course, that leads to incredible 0 to 60 times as well, especially if tuned and modified. So you can see 0 to 60s with a tune and a couple bolt-ons in the low twos, you know, 2.2, 2.3 seconds to 60 miles an hour. Even bone stock, I believe the M3 and M4 are high twos, maybe 2.8, 2.9 seconds, 0 to 60. So already incredible performance from the factory. A couple simple mods take that even further. On stock turbos, we've already seen a number of S58s make 700, 750 wheel horsepower. The Red Bull Drift Brothers took the car, stock engine, stock internals. They did do a little bit of cylinder head work, and we're running on, I believe, kind of a lower grade race gas when they did the testing. Of course, upgraded turbos and, you know, all the basic bolt-ons. But they took the engine to over 1,000 horsepower at the crank and believed it had still had power left in it and that it wasn't stressing the factory motor or the factory internals. So how much power these engines make and can hold in the long term, still a question mark, since again, these are newer engines. A lot are under warranty. The wait list to actually get one is pretty lengthy too, so there just aren't a ton of them out there yet, which makes it all the more impressive that these cars have already accomplished so much in such a little time period. So it seems like the sky's the limit for the S58. Certainly still has a long way to go and a lot to prove to see how much power they can truly make for the long term. But it doesn't seem unrealistic on a stock motor for these things to make 800 plus wheel horsepower and still be reliable in the process and not really putting the internals at risk. Now again, anytime you increase power that much, especially going from the factory, the S58 makes 503 horsepower and 479 pound-feet of torque. Typically, it actually makes a little bit closer to that at the wheels, or a little bit less than that to the wheels. So about what BMW quotes the crank horsepower is actually about what they make to the wheels. But still, when you're adding, you know, 300 plus wheel horsepower, there is a lot of risk and anything could happen. But ultimately, these engines are looking like they should hold up to the challenge and hold up to the task. And, you know, 700 to 750 wheel horsepower on stock turbos is just insane performance for a 3-liter twin turbo engine. And again, that's really being accomplished with pretty much nothing other than a tune, upgraded downpipes, an intake, and then an E85 blend. Now, if you do want to make that power safely on E85, you probably should consider adding a port injection setup just to have that additional headroom and that additional fuel flow. Make sure you're not leading out the engine, since obviously you don't want to be running lean if you're making 750 plus wheel horsepower and a little 3-liter engine. Ultimately, I believe at the time the S58 is currently the best engine on the market. It offers pretty much unparalleled performance for an engine of its size. And again, even comparing it to much larger 5-6 liter forced induction V8s, even those engines struggle to achieve the same power and performance as the S58. So the fact it's doing that as a little 3-liter inline six is pretty incredible, and it's come such a long way from the start with the N54 And that's what's even more incredible. You know, the 135i behind me with the N54, we're throwing a single turbo on that soon enough here. But it's crazy to think that these cars can barely achieve the kind of performance that the S58 is making on, you know, stock turbos with a couple basic bolt-ons. These cars, even with, you know, limited slip differentials, upgrading that, upgrading the axles, upgrading the transmission or the clutch, whatever it be, whether you have the 6MT or the automatic transmission, you need all the bolt-ons, a huge single turbo, probably a built engine to safely make, you know, 650 plus wheel horsepower for the long term. And so the amount of work and money that has to go into the N54 to take it to that kind of performance just goes to show how much more impressive the S58 is, in the sense that it can blow those numbers out of the water with just a couple basic bolt-on mods. So again, S58, very exciting engine, something that is certainly worth keeping an eye on moving forward. Of course, at this time, they're still new engines. They're nearly impossible to source in the aftermarket, and they are very expensive engines as of now. So if you're looking to swap anything, you know, the S58 probably isn't an appealing option as of now, but certainly an engine worth keeping an eye on in the future to see what the S58 ends up being capable of. And it certainly seems like it'll go down as one of the greatest engines, you know, up there with the likes of the Nissan RB engines and the Toyota 2JZ and, you know, really a lot of those legendary inline sixes. Ultimately, not much else to say about the S58 other than we'll certainly have tons more content coming for this engine in the future, as well as hopefully adding one to the garage at some point to make some content for the G80 M3 and the S58 engine. If you guys like this video, please hit that like button, smash the subscribe button, and check out the description below for more awesome content on the BMW S58, as well as tons of other engines and cars. Thanks, guys.